Welcome to r/I don't work here, lady, where we share stories about folks that are mistaken for employees by irate customers. And the first story is, I'm too young to work, but who cares? Hello, this is my first post here, so I don't know if it fits. I'm a 14-year-old female. As you can tell, I'm too young to work. But do I look older, you may ask? No, I have a baby face and I'm very, very short. This story takes place at night, around 8 p.m. My mother went out for dinner with her friends, and I was going to stay with my dad at home. But he got a call from his boss. He sometimes works as a substitute teacher when needed. And he told me he had to go. I said okay, but he was very worried to leave me alone at home, and asked his boss if I could come. His boss said I could. I took my book and stayed at the teacher's room with the other teachers. Everything was going fine, until one of the teachers next to me got a call. A mom wanted to talk to her. The teacher didn't even have time to answer, and this lady stormed into the room. She threw her bag and her coat at me, and I stared at her confused. She noticed. Lady, what are you looking at? Me, why did you throw these? Lady, this is your F-word job, don't complain. Me, what? I don't work here. Lady, of course you do. What else would you be doing here? Me, I'm... She cuts me off. Lady, you do work here. You're probably a school dropout. Don't talk to me, you lazy trash. I started to cry, and the other teachers came to help me. I dropped her coat and this lady freaked out. Lady, look at what you did! You! Racial slur, even though we were both white. After 2 minutes of her cursing at me, the security came and forcibly removed her. I asked the teachers if we could just forget that, and nobody ever told my dad. The next story is, when your own coworkers don't even know what you do. First and foremost, please excuse any errors in my spelling. I'm a bit dyslexic and English is not my first language. Thank you for understanding. Second, a bit of background. I work for a parcel delivery company and my job is to fix parcels that have problems with the labels. If the address is wrong, give parcels to customers at our hub's pickup location, finding phone numbers and email to people who we're going to deliver parcels to, etc. However, I'm not exactly customer service. The only calls I take are from people that have problems with labels. Nothing to do with late pickups, drivers having not delivered correctly, that sort of thing. 3. I'm not totally sure if this post fits here, but I'd say it's close enough. Now, my coworkers should know that, but sometimes it seems they either don't know what kind of work I do or they ignore it. I have a few examples. 1. I was working one day when I got a call from a customer service rep from a different hub. We have about 8 in my country, and I pick up the phone, thinking it's something to do with the label. What I got was not this customer service rep, but an angry man, complaining about how his parcels had not been picked up yet. I told him that I'm sorry, but that's not my department. He didn't give 2 flying Fs and demanded that I got the driver to come and pick up his parcels. After telling him again that it's not my department, and I can't even see who's pick up parcels in his area, he asked me to transfer him to someone who could help. Now, our phone system is run 100% via computer. Problem is, I was not instructed in how to use it, how to transfer calls and such. My company's not very good when it comes to teaching people how the new tech work, even if they use it every day. I told him I could not do that because I hardly knew who he was going to talk to, and asked him to please call our main number again, which he eventually did. I wrote the customer service rep an email and told her that I didn't have anything to do with parcel pickups, and I thought that was it. But no, she continued to forward these calls to me almost every day for the next week. It wasn't until I got my supervisor involved that it stopped. 2. I have a customer service rep at the hub that I work at, who, let's just say, is not the brightest spark in the fire. One day she called me and told me that there was a guy on the phone that I needed to talk to. Thinking again it was about a label problem, I said sure, and she forwarded him to me. What I got was a guy whose parcel had not been delivered for a few days. According to our driver, he was not home, and he couldn't get into the building to place the parcel. And he was furious, demanding an explanation on why his parcel had not been delivered. Demanding an express delivery, which I can't authorize, and basically calling the company useless. I explained that I didn't know why his parcel had not been delivered, and that I wasn't customer service, to which he replied, "Then why the heck am I talking to you then?" I was just thinking, ask my coworker who forwarded you to me. I told him I would look into it as best as I could, and I would get the parcel out for delivery on the next coming weekday. This was a Friday, so it would be delivered on Monday. He got quiet and breathed heavily. I knew he was about to explode. He did eventually calm down, and after profusely apologizing for the inconvenience, I called the customer service rep and asked why she had forwarded this call to me. She replied, "Well, I figured you could explain this to him better. Lady, you're customer service. That's your job." I talked to my supervisor and he talked to her afterwards, so I thought that was the end of it. Wrong, wrong, wrong. A little while later, I'm on the phone with another customer, when the same customer service rep shoots me an email with a phone number followed by her writing, "Call, thanks." I wrote back, why? But didn't get an answer. Knowing that I often get calls from people about label problems and that they're sometimes in a hurry, I make the mistake and call the number. What I got was an older lady who was extremely angry about not having received a parcel a few days earlier and was also furious about not having been notified that we had been on the address. I told her that I had tried to find a phone number for her, and she said her number was on the internet, and she called me a liar. She wasn't the receiver of the parcel, it was her husband, and I couldn't find a number for him to be exact. Then it was another 10 minutes of me, despite it not being my job, trying to explain how our policies work and how I could not authorize express delivery, and everything I said just made her even more angry and made her chew me out even more. I told her I would make some calls and see what I could do, and she finally hung up. I went to my supervisor and asked him for a number for the transport manager. Supervisor, why do you need his number? Me, customer service asked me to call someone who, as it appears, wanted a parcel delivered with express delivery due to an apparent mistake from the driver. Supervisor, wait, that's not your job. You're not supposed to call people about stuff like that. That's customer service's job. Me, I know, but they asked me to call and didn't explain what it was about, so I thought it had something to do with the label problem. Supervisor, who asked you to call that number? Me, tells my supervisor who in customer service that asked me to call. Supervisor, again? Me, yup. Supervisor, I'll go talk to her. And the reason she wanted me to call this lady? I didn't feel like I was getting through to this lady. I felt you were much better at getting through to her. I hate my job sometimes. The third story is, the time one of them actually got to speak to the manager, and it was my manager. This happened a couple of years ago, but I was reading an Ask Reddit thread that jogged this memory to come up. Anyway, I think it was like 2016-ish, and I was working as a receptionist in an office. My boss slash owner of the business was actually a very good friend of mine that I had known for a really long time. Anyway, she would occasionally give her employees gift cards to different places to buy some more work attire, as the dress code kept changing as the business did. I took mine and set out to Target. I was in the fitting room trying on some stuff when I hear what sounds like a stern, angry bee talking. When I come out, it is in fact a stern, angry bee talking. She is standing with, who I assume is her daughter, in front of a mirror that was in the hall of the dressing room areas, but not in the room itself. She's basically railing into this poor girl who can't be more than 13 or 14 about how if she lost weight, clothes might actually look good on her. This lady was actually pretty big herself. Not that this is a bad thing, but hypocrisy and mental abuse is. The poor girl looked defeated, and I kinda watched them as I handed my items I didn't want back to the girl working, and said something along the lines of, "Man, some people suck," in a voice I thought was pretty low. I guess it wasn't. The bee thought the girl working the counter said it at first, and started to go after her. I told her I said it, because that girl didn't know me and didn't need to lose her job over me. I mean, I'm sure you can guess what happens next. She wants to speak to my manager. I try the whole I don't work here thing, but her rebuttal is that I obviously do. I'm obviously here on my day off, and should still be reprimanded for being rude about a customer to my little friend. Not that I wouldn't be friends with the girl working there, she seemed lovely, but we had never met before, to my knowledge anyway. I'm about to tell her that when a new idea dawns on me. "Yeah, you can talk to my manager," I tell her, getting my phone out. "I just have to call her because she isn't here today." Entirely true. My manager was at home that day getting ready for a party I was later attending at her house. I call her, she answers. I say, "Hey, I have someone here at Target demanding to speak to you." There is some quite obvious confusion on her end. All I hear is, "Okay," before putting her on speakerphone. I'll be D if a stranger is gonna press my phone against their face. "Okay, you're on speaker." Immediately, B McBee Pants starts telling her how awful I am and what I did, and is also adding spice that it's awful that no manager is on the floor to deal with this situation today. My boss started laughing hysterically, which made B Bridges even more angry. "Well, if you ask for a random person's manager, don't be surprised that they don't work at Target, you idiot." I lost it at this point too. I apologized to the nice young lady working the rooms, put my phone to my ear so I could laugh it off with my friend slash manager, and started to walk away. Of course, Bienstein is still yelling at me because I'm awful, and I see what I assume is an actual manager coming over to the rooms. So I tell my manager I'll call her back, and head back to see what lies she tries to spin, and also try to make sure she doesn't accuse fitting room girl of anything. Lo and behold, she was trying to blame that girl, and started yelling about that bee, me this time, coming back, and I should be punished too. Luckily, the manager saw me and immediately says, "I've never seen her before in my life, she doesn't work here." Angry lady says she can't deal with her lies anymore, grabs her poor, embarrassed beyond all reason daughter and is walking away. The manager apologized to me and the employee, but it's not like I ever blamed him, he was super kind. Once I got to my car, I felt bad that I didn't give the daughter the rest of my Target gift card, but I knew there was no way I could have. So I called my manager back and just about died laughing about the situation. And the last story is, Karen has a freak out at Walmart. This I will never forget. I used to work at my local Walmart, but I only worked there for 3 months, then quit, because I couldn't work the schedule I was on. I work the graveyard shift. That means I work from 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. Fun. I quit because I would sleep all day and be up all night, have no time for family or friends, and I couldn't do that, nor was I able to switch to the day shift, since there was no openings for the day shift. After 3 weeks of me quitting, I returned to do some shopping and to return my vest and name tag. I was standing at the customer service, waiting for the general manager to come get the vest and tag. As I was waiting, this woman, aka Karen, walks right up to me and crossed her arms and snarls at me. Me, can I help you? Karen, yes, I've been waiting for you to stop talking for nearly an hour. Me, I've been here for 5 minutes, what do you want? Karen, I need help. I want to buy a TV, but I can't carry it. Me, I don't work here, lady. The customer service girl holds in a giggle as she tries to calm down the Karen. Karen, yes you do. You do work here. I saw you just a month ago working here. Me, I quit like 3 weeks ago. I no longer work here. If you want help, how about you lose the SH Karen attitude of yours and nicely ask for help before demanding someone? No wonder why people think you're a B. We had problems with her multiple times. Karen goes on and on how she's gonna get me fired for this and how she knows the general manager. Me, go ahead, I don't care, I don't work here. I put the tag and vest down on the counter and did my shopping. The general manager comes up and fist bumps me, as it was our way of saying hey to each other. He tells me what Karen said and laughed. GM, I swear that woman is crazy. I tried to tell her that you don't work here. Me, that's what I told her. GM, don't worry if she does anything, she'll be banned. I finish up my shopping and what do you know, Karen slapped the general manager for being so inconsistent, of her being assaulted by me. I didn't even put my hands on her. And next thing she knew, she was banned and arrested for attacking the elderly. The general manager is 86. I hope you enjoyed these stories. If you like it, don't forget to leave your feedback and hit the like button.